So the only thing I'm thinking about doing here is to have some sort of confirmation before it deletes our worksheets. Because right now, if we just accidentally just go and click on this delete, it's just going to run. So maybe after we hit delete, we want to have some sort of prompt. Are you sure you want to delete this, basically? Something like that. Let's actually go to Metro UI and see if they have anything like that here. I think they had something like a dialogue or something. Let's take a look. See, something like that. So there's button disagree, button agree, create a dialogue. Yep, that's what we want. So let's take a look. See, this is even better. It has red for our buttons. And it seems like they also have some function event handlers, which will be perfect for us. I think this is what I'm gonna use. So what I'll do, I'll just basically copy this script right in here. And we don't need the script tags. We already have them. So just this much. Go back. And I'm going to scroll down and add that function in here. Let's just do some indentation here. And what I'll do, I'll save this function inside of this object again. So I'll do this dot that equals a function, which will basically be this. We can call it something else here. So this function, see, it runs this code and it creates this use Windows location service. So basically that's what part of it was it? It's this part and this is the text in the middle. So we're gonna change those. So that's the title on top. This is going to be the rest of our text. And we need two buttons. See, one of the buttons is this. So I'm just going to say delete. And this one will be cancel. And when they click on this delete, it's going to basically do this. And it's going to run this alert. For us, if they click cancel, we don't need to run any alerts, so I'm just gonna get rid of that. I'll just do a comment, do nothing. And in case they do click delete, we actually want to run the delete. So now what's gonna change is that instead of me, when I click on this delete, run that function that deletes the worksheet, I want when they click on this delete button to show that dialogue. So I'm gonna change the event handler for that button to run this. So I'm going to scroll down. This is when we click on a button. I'm going to say open that dialog, basically. This function. Let's actually comment this too. Now, in the event they actually click delete on the dialog here instead of alert, I want to actually delete those worksheets. This is where I'm going to run that function to delete sheets, this. So I'm gonna copy that, go back to this, and replace this with that function. And we wanna run it, so I'm gonna add parentheses, open, close. Just like that. So I think that should work. Let's just try this. So I'm gonna go here, open this. We got all of these. If I click to delete the sheet 13 and hit delete, see, it didn't delete the worksheet. It says, warning, you're about to delete selected worksheets. Are you sure? So I'm just gonna do cancel. So nothing, good. Now let's try to delete it. And it's gone. Good. It works. Maybe in this prompt, we can also just do a count. We'll say you're about to delete, let's say, 7 worksheet or however many is selected. And that we should be able to do, hopefully. Now we need to get the count to actually populate it in here. So to do that, we need to do that. See this thing that gets us the items that are selected. I'm just going to rerun this line to make this simpler. I'm just going to take all of this, copy this line, and paste it right in here when we open the dialog. And what I'll do here, I'll just basically calculate the length of this. And that should be how many items we have in that list that are checked. And I'll just say worksheet count. So then I want to use that count in here. I'll say you're about to delete some number of worksheets. So what I'll do here, I'll open and close parentheses, and I'm just gonna convert these quotations to backticks, which is the key right next to one on top, right next to exclamation key. And right in here, I'll do $ brackets and pass that worksheet count inside of those parentheses. So this way, if I go back and reload this and check, see, it says you're about to delete 2 worksheets. I do cancel. If I do more, it's gonna do 3. And there it is. The only thing I want to add to this is to make sure that whoever's using this has never all the worksheets selected, because you're not going to be able to delete every single worksheet in a spreadsheet. We need to at least have one. So what I'll do right in here before we run this thing that we just did, we'll do some sort of if statement. And that if statement will probably need to have this in there anyways. The worksheet count. So we'll do it here. So we need to get the worksheet count. So this will be whatever selected. Maybe this should be selected worksheet count. Let's update it here too. So I want to compare selected worksheet count with the total worksheet count in here. To get the total worksheet count, let's look at their docs. So it says get selected items. I guess get items would be what we need. So I'm just gonna copy this. And as a matter of fact, we don't need to map this because we just need the length. So let's just do this. And for this one, like that, and this will be get items instead of get selected items. That should be the whole list, hopefully. So I'm just gonna call this one worksheet count. So basically what I'll do here, I'll say if our selected worksheet count equals to our worksheet count, then we have pretty much everything selected. So at this point, we shouldn't allow to have anything deleted. Now you could also do another if case if it's 0, so you don't display that too in case there are 0 items selected. I'm just gonna do else. And basically I'm just gonna move all of this right in here inside of that else statement. Let's just do a comment here. And I'm gonna move all of this by dragging it right inside of this. And this would be else closing. Basically, if these are equal, we're gonna have to do something else. Otherwise, we'll do whatever we used to do. So basically, we just need some sort of dialogue created, and we should be able to use probably the same code here and simplify it. So I'm going to copy that and paste it right in here. And I assume all we have to do is just get rid of buttons. Well, just one of them, I guess. And this will simply just be okay. And it's going to be doing nothing. So we'll just say, you didn't select any worksheets. And here we'll just give it a different title. Whatever you want to do. So I'm going to save this. Let's go back and take a look. So reload this thing. So now nothing is selected. If I delete, actually I was doing this when everything was selected. Let's actually do for everything selected. That should see do everything. If I hit delete, it says you didn't. Actually this should be, you can't delete all worksheets. All right. I forgot what I was doing apparently as I was doing this. Anyways, select all of this, hit delete. See, it says error, you can't delete all worksheets. We hit okay, it's gone. If we select a couple of these, hit delete, it's gonna give us this warning. Hit delete, that should delete those worksheets. Looks pretty good.